Next up, in the world of something completely different, the mysterious aviator, the kinetic dragonfly. This was sent over by a company that handcrafts these and produces them and sells them. It's like a steampunk kind of thing. And we know that Chris loves anything to do with putting things together and devices and little machines and all that kind of stuff. So I was really excited to get this. And when I received it, I was blown away by the quality of the stuff that's in here and how nice it is. So for one, it comes in this awesome little toolbox case. So when you're all done, you get to keep this. You could peel this label off and this little toolbox case is yours. But that's not even close to it, to what's in the box. We've got more and more stuff. We've got a beautiful, which usually does not happen from these companies, a beautiful full color manual telling you what every single part is, labeling it, giving you beautiful 3D drawings, exactly where parts should go, their orientation with all the others, little sidebars, put the little hole here, put the big hole there, all that kind of awesome stuff, and gets you through the whole build process, so it will not be nearly as complicated as I thought. Now, there's more stuff in this box, but let's take some stuff out. We got a beautiful metal rod. This, I'm guessing, because it's threaded on both ends, that's our display base. So you can already see this is going to be a nice big machine. That's my big mitt there. We've got, here we go, we start getting into the cool stuff right away. We got, and it's metal gears, not plastic. We got a little gearbox with a DC motor on it and plenty of extra wire. Looks like we may have to do a little soldering. We'll see, unless they got wire nuts in there. That's not hard to do. But yeah, we got a little bit of, what is that? It says it's a 3 to 6 volt DC motor. Nice pre-oiled gearbox. You can see all the oil in there. So that's all set to go. This box here, we've got all these little mini toolboxes inside. This one has got a little sanding stick, model sanding stick, actually two of them in there. It's got a USB power supply. Looks like it's got a USB extension cable in there. It's got a battery box with an on-off switch. Oh, and nice, they give us, we got another USB, some sort of a USB, maybe it's for programming? All right, well, it's got a potentiometer on one end, so we're going to find out how that adjusts things. We got a four-way wrench. You folks in radio control, like I am, will recognize that from everything. Tweezers, Allen wrench, screwdriver, and a nice set of brand new needle nose pliers. Who can't use more needle nose? So we got that in the box. Man, that's a lot of cool stuff. I mean, really, you don't have to get any tools or anything. We got a box of hardware here, all labeled with those numbers we saw in the manual. Open that carefully. All divided up, brass, chrome, aluminum hardware. That is top notch. Wish they'd organize my Legos this way. This box, we've got hardware labeled beautifully. I'll open this one really carefully. Yeah, don't go throwing that one around. Ay, ay, ay. And when you're done, you're going to have storage. Beautiful brass screws in there. Or maybe gold anodized. I'm not sure which one they are. We got the box here. Let's put that on the side. But that's not everything that's in the kit. Let's get to some of the major pieces. We've got wood and gold anodized pieces. And they are a beautiful stained color. And they smell good because it's natural wood. So we'll just take some of them out, take a look. These are the wings to our dragonfly. All pre-drilled holes. Laser cut parts that have been cleaned up and stained. Really nice stuff going on here. We're going to have four of those. We've got all these different excellent pieces of wood. Clearly these are part of like the assembly of the wings or the body of the dragonfly. We got a bunch of these half circles. We've got small U-shaped parts back here. So I'm just going to go through and show you the nice wood parts. We'll move on to the metal parts. Got some what looks like cams here. Remember, this thing will move. It won't just stand there. It's actually going to, or it's supposed to operate. So I'm really impressed. Looks like A-arm holders on an RC car where they support rods going through the center for rigidity. So maybe that's it. We got these little donuts of hardwood installed there. Now check this out. Doesn't end with just those parts. Look at these. Look at these like little flywheels. Stamped out. Excellent. Nice. You could even go through. You could probably go through and polish these up if you wanted. I like the rougher steampunk kind of used universe look. But that, I mean, that's real metal. They're nice heavy pieces, nice size. Check out the veins for the wings. All shiny. This thing's going to be so beautiful when I get it done. Even got more cross bracing. I mean, it's really going to be exquisite. Look at these unique kind of pieces. Such cool stuff in there. All that. I just can't wait to see. And the final part I saved. Look at the display base. It's got a plastic cover on it right now, but it says Mysterious Aviator. Rubber feet. Looks like an, oh yeah, access hatch for power. It's a solid wood base that they've drilled through. We've got a plug in the back. We've got the base with some set screws, I'm guessing for that metal rod, and a really cool all-metal toggle switch instead of plastic. That is sweet. So that is everything that's in the box with the Mysterious Aviator. I'm going to get to working on it by following these instructions. I'll come back at different sub-assembly times. There is nothing to paint. We're just going to start putting things together, and I'll see you in a minute. This point here is about 3 hours worth of assembly, maybe four. I took a little bit of a break to fix an injury. The screwdriver that's included is pretty useless. I really, you know, it's good, but I've been using my own precision style screwdrivers that you can get that you can spin in your thumbs and all that, because the construction can be a little, some of the holes on the brass components are not drilled the proper size. I think the punches that are punching out these parts are getting a little worn and the holes are getting a little too small for the screws that go through. And I slipped and self-injected a screwdriver a half an inch into my hand. So I do recommend switching to nicer screwdrivers. The pliers, the tweezers, the four-way wrench, and the hex wrench work absolutely fine. Those are fine. But some of the holes you can see, like, I've got three bolts into this hole and one is not there. Now, I could drill that out, but three is more than enough to hold it, and that's where I injured myself. It's just not lined up properly in there. It's not drilled through the right way. So you could see the components individualized. Everything, the construction is very straightforward. You're going to be able to figure things out. You're going to be able to mirror image your wings so you get four opposite wings. You don't want them to be identical or it's going to fly in complete circles every time. We've got our A-arms here. These are identically built, and then you just put them on either sides of the Dragonfly. These are pretty cool looking assemblies. All that brass componentry and U-joints and all that stuff, it is actually really cool. Just pay attention to orientation. See the high and low parts there. Make sure you follow what the manual says and do exactly what it says, where it says to do it. We've got our little gearbox and motor in there. Our little splines, that's where these drive wheels on the sides are going to connect and screw around. We've got our power cable that will be routed through the pole in the base and out the bottom. And then it's just a screw connector. There'll be no soldering. It just screw connects to the bottom once it comes out. And then we will be plugging in our power supply and be able to operate it. So all I have left is the final assembly, pushing all these parts together, using some screws to hold them together, and then hooking it up and make sure it works. So I'm going to work on that, and I'll be right back. And you can hear it whirring and buzzing as it goes around. Final assembly is quite easy, except for one thing. Down in the base there where I showed you the wires, some genius that assembled it put the black and red wires on the wrong side. So when I hooked up the wires to it and color corrected them, black to black and red to red, the whole machine ran backwards. So I had to open it up and reverse the wires and connect them in the correct way. Then when I turned it on and plugged in the USB power supply, it started running forward the way it should. So be aware of that. If it runs the wrong direction, you'll have to do their wiring for them and reverse the wires. We've also got what I am positive is a motor that is simply not strong enough to run the device properly. It's a very, very small motor. It's geared quite a bit in there. And what we're getting is some binding during the heaviest point of trying to get the wings up. Now, I know none of the mechanics are binding because I've checked them all. I've made sure the wings don't touch. I've made sure that they just get close to each other, and I've made sure the U-joints move freely and there is correct spacing amongst everything. There are other channels that built this and they had the exact same problem. Is that my opinion, they thought it was this internal part here and that is moving freely. The issue is simply the size of the motor. Running off 5 volts DC is not enough speed or torque in that little motor to get everything moving. So that seems to be an issue with it as well. So with the holes not being the proper size and having to drill out a lot of them, and the final running, which can be a little laggy, and see, you can hear that motor really struggling to get things to go around, even though the mechanism with the motor detached freewheels beautifully. So do I recommend this kit? Well, one of the very few times I'm going to say this on the channel, at this price point, what this sells for, no, I don't recommend it at this price. For 75 bucks, yes. But at the price that they are asking, unfortunately, and they're not going to like this, but it's true, and it's the same as what other channels said, it needs some redesigning. It does. It's absolutely beautiful. I mean, look at it. It is very, very beautiful. As it goes around, the wings look nice. It is a real piece of art, but it does need some help. And at this price point, I don't think anyone should have to re-engineer or drill more holes or design anything differently. But you can see how beautiful it is once it gets going. It looks lovely. We'll get it away from the backdrop so it doesn't bind the wings. But I mean, it's a beautiful work of art. It's beautifully done. It assembles quite easily, aside from the holes being a little small. And it looks nice. But again, at this price point, it needs too much work for me to recommend it to my viewers. So hopefully the company will come back with a little bit of a redesign, make sure the holes are nice. I could spend, you know, it took me about a half an hour extra to get those holes opened up. I would think you'd be able to build this if the holes were the right size and the motor was wired correctly within 3 hours and have a lot of fun with it. But as it is, I'm gonna have to say it's a pass. It is a beautiful piece of work. You can go to their website. They've got a lot of non-moving models that are absolutely exquisite. I'd like a chance to build those to give you my opinion of them. I think without them having to move, they're gonna be very beautiful. But again, I like it. I'm really glad they sent it over. They're very nice people. But again, gave me some issues that, you know, screws that don't fit and you ram the screwdriver through your finger and stuff, through your hand and stuff like that, because you're trying to make things work and stuff like that. But if they could work it out, if they could put a bigger motor in between, change the gearing a little bit, and improve the size of the holes, it'd be a 10 out of 10. As it is right now at this price point, 6 out of 10. If it was hundreds of dollars less, 9 out of 10. Because then you'd expect to have to do a little fine finagling and working. But at this price point, I insist that it worked perfectly out of the box, and it simply doesn't. So I don't ever like to be negative, but I do need to tell the truth to my viewers, and that's how I see it. As always, thanks for watching the workshop. We'll see all of you at the next review. It is a beautiful work of art, but again, just my opinion at this time. I think it needs a little bit more before being released to the public. We'll see all of you at the next review.